Now we said something about that. What if the ball is outside the zone? Will you keep leaving it all the time?
No.
Sometimes you have to. You have to test the patience of the bowler. Because who knows, after four balls of bowling there, you would say, man, check it, man, he is not playing. Let me go on those stumps and that's when you play. Right? So sometimes when you're playing a 30-over game, 40-over games, 45, 50-over games, you have to test the patience of the bowler also. And as a bowler, you have to test the patience of the batsman. Let's say you realize that as a he's leaving, he's a good batsman, man. He's leaving. He's not touching my outside of ball. What will you do as a bowler? Keep on bowling outside. Don't commit to his plan.
Yeah. But as a batsman,
don't fall into his trap. Now as a batsman, what will you do? Yes, you test their patience. In 40 overs or 45 overs, you surviving six balls, a good ball. I'm not saying a short ball you defended. Short ball you do act. But a good ball, if you're surviving, you are the better one. You are not falling into his trap. Now what will happen? Second over, your captain will say, man, what to do? To give him over or not? He's not taking wicket, nothing. So he will give that over. Bowler is also a little bit frustrated, man. He's not doing anything. What should I do? He will bowl on the stumps, and that's when you take one run, two run, drive and what. You have to play with the patience of the bowler. Bowler has to play with the patience of the batsman. The better one will prevail.
And no bowler, right, can bowl, like if he can bowl all the six balls in the same channel, then he is a good bowler. But at this level, or even like the level, like three levels above, right, there is no bowler who can bowl four balls there.
Yeah. So he will give one bad ball.
Eventually, after this over, second over, he is tired. Third over or second, no bowler can bowl all six balls in the same channel. Just understand that. You have to wait for your opportunity.
You have to wait for that right ball that you can score once, two, three. Guys, this is the end of the theory part of this class. Any questions before we go for actual batting and applying this what we have learned in our life? Any questions from anybody?